British food, I think, is first class. It's somehow clean, satisfying.
English food is very bland, isn't it?
Oh, yeah, but I'm not terribly spicy, I'm not either.
Oh,
well, I like the spices, and the spices don't like me, you know what I mean?
Mm. No, I like spices, and I like all kinds. There's nothing around here anyway, is there?
The trouble with the foods we eat now, there's too much fat in them. And the worst thing that happens in this country, there's too many people eat chips.
Ooh. Egg and chips. Egg chips, gammon. Chip butties.
I mean, at lunchtime, instead of kiddies going down and buying a couple of apples or a couple of pears, what do? They go to the chip shops and buy chips. And when they get home at night, they have chips again.
You know, if I have too much chocolate, I get a bit fat and I put on a lot of weight.
Yeah, she eats really well for a diet. I mean, I pile weights on and she piles it off. So I think what she loses, I gain.
I try and eat healthily.
And she eats brown bread and all the rest of it. Apples and bananas, you name it, she eats it.
The main staple diet for runners is...
We had, in fact, we had wild strawberries, little wild strawberries. And of course, if it was acorn time, you could always eat an acorn. And even the thistle, you could always peel the top off of the thistle.
Are you talking about food, like, or duration? They're like everything. You know, not one particular, like a Mexican or a thing. That's no good for me.
There are one or two foreign foods that do have rice pudding, proper pizzas, you know, like some of the deep pan pizzas.
The crust on top, amazing, and then that gooey stuff inside. But that sort of poo is a lot healthier, horse poo and cow poo. Cowpats are fantastic to look at, they with all those dung beetles crawling around inside them.
As long as it's filling and barely edible, I'll pretty much eat it. I'm always too hungry to be picky.
I didn't like to eat anything really that was contaminated by any insect. Although we put up with it when you're hungry. I never ate it that I know of. may have done. I don't know.
Horse poo is very good. You know. But human poo and dog poo, that's poisonous, I think.
Yeah, but if you eat a bit of dirt, it don't matter, does it?
No, they reckon you eat a pound of dirt anyway. In your lifetime, they reckon you eat a pound of dirt.
God.
Without even knowing.
I used to go around the back of shops, supermarkets, going down the back of the skips to get the chocolate out. Yeah, I've eaten food that's been a week old and what have you. Anything from frozen to tins. I used to find all sorts of food in the skips. I was, like, liberating it.
And then there's elephant poo, which is enormous. And lion's poo. Now, that must frighten anybody off.
I don't catch flies because they eat poo, and I don't like poo.
Like eating dirt, you got your trace elements in there, aren't you?
Yeah.
You know, and it builds up your resistance to infection as well. So it ain't a bad thing, I don't think.
Dirt on food. Dirt on food. What? Dirt on food can kill you. You can put one mouthful of dirty food in your mouth and you can be a goner. Can you ask me that question?
I think I've ate more lead shot than I've certainly ate oysters. I think that's probably, I don't know, it's probably why my brain's a bit funny or, yeah.
Dog and cat food.
It smells absolutely disgusting,
well,
doesn't it?
Well, it's very strong.
Horrible.
It's very strong.
Oh, I don't think I'd like to eat a sheep's eyeball or an intestine of a cow or something like that. But if you've got all these sort of intestines and all these sort of, you know, not so appetizing bits of animals, then they mix it all up in a mixer and then they call it
I don't want to sound like a cannibal, but deer again, we all went out for a meal and the chicken was so horrible. I could vomit all night and never stop. That was really, really horrible.
Horrible?
Yeah, bloody milk cartons. Goes everywhere, milk, anything. There's too many bags in the world.
God help the people with arthritis. Yes, they never open them.
They can't.
It's terrible.
Even to tea bags, to get them
something. The cellophane on it, you can't open it. The biscuits, you can't open. All packages.
And a packet of ham, which I don't very well.
It's terrible. They're not, none of the packages.
By the time you open it, you don't want the ham. No.
Oh, gosh, yes.
I hate seafood. I really, absolutely detest it. I did eat a fish once about 2 years ago, and it was, I think they're disgusting.
Now, I, you know, like prawns and all the shellfish. I mean, I know they're lovely, but I'm always afraid in case you get the one that'll turn
your stomach.
Whelks, mussels. That's like eating slugs.
Is it?
Oysters and stuff.
I've never tasted a slug.
Ugh, sliding down your gullet.
But you don't eat slugs,
like
do you?
Like eating a slug.
Well, how do you know when you've never had one?
That's how I would imagine it to be.
I love salads. Same as I'd rather have a salad than a roast dinner.
We eat a lot of salad in the summer, don't we? Mm. More in the winter.
Salt, a bit of tomato. Can't beat a bit of salt.
Can't beat a bit of lettuce.
Well, I mean, I feel very healthy. The only thing that I have problems with is digestion, and I don't know what is wrong with my digestion. I mean, it's just like, I just fart all the time, you know?
I've got a windy stomach. So, like, a lot of things I would not eat if it would upset me. But other than that, no, I'm not a diet person.
Vegetarian is all right, but when they cut out everything, because some of them don't eat, well, they're vegans, is it?
Vegans.
Yeah. I think that's hard.
I've been a vegetarian a long time. And when I'm angry, I sometimes lapse and just go and bite something that's made out of meat. And then I feel guilty afterwards.
Vegetarians. I think they're sort of trying to be better than the rest of us. You know, it's been proved, as far as I know, that the best thing to eat is a bit of yourself.
Actually, beans gives me wind and lemonade makes me burp.
What are you looking at?
Thank you very much.